We are off to the Kalahari. It's a semi-arid desert. We're going to what's basically a colony of the Khoisan people. It's the original inhabitants, one of the oldest civilizations in the world, and importantly, Africa. Yeah, I'm expecting to see the original man, the origin of graffiti or street art.
Hello.
Hello, my name is Falko.
Jan.
Jan. Jan was the first bushman that I've met in my life. I'm sure that he's been a guide to many people before, but not a guide to an actual graffiti project. Ek het ook gekom om 'n paar huise te verf, om 'n paar murals te doen op 'n paar huise. So ek wil hê miskien jy moet my help om permissie te kry om saam net die locals te praat. That moment I was a bit anxious. This is the first time for me as an artist where I'm coming to a place where I knew that they wouldn't know what graffiti is.
Okay. So ek die deel met die geel.
Okay.
Movement.
Dag sê almal. Hallo. Ek gaan aan my kennis.
Yes, ek Boesman Koper.
Ek het gou 'n vraag. Ek het onlangs gehoor dat dit verkeerd om Boesman te sê.
Ja.
Nee,
jy moet sê Boesman. Nee, nie vir ons gemoedstoestelling. Ek meen, dit laat my goed voel.
If you go into a foreign community and the very first house you have an issue with, it could mean that you end up having an issue with everybody else. If we get the first house to say yes and I paint something that sells the idea of what I'm doing, then it's smooth sailing. En ek hou van olifante. Dit is baie.
Hy dink is mos baie sterk.
Ja,
kom oor die klein jy op.
En moenie laat hy Amarula gedrink het
nie. Jy jy kan sien ek kan oral in Suid-Afrika. So ek was nog nooit hier nie toe ek gesê jy.
Ja, nee, jy moet hier kom.
Ja,
daai by die Kalahari.
So ek wil baie graag gewoon die kante van die huis doen as jy ou toestemming gee.
Nee.
Ek gaan môre oggend vroeg kom, 5:30 in die oggend terwyl dit nog koel is.
Ja.
Okay.
Ja.
Sal jy later sien? Dankie.
Nee, we ons sien.
Ja. Hy was mooi.
Dis 'n vriend.
Ja, maar hy was mooi.
Baie dankie vir die dag, my broer.
In the valley. There my heart sings, there'll be no strings, I'm worth nothing.
So it's morning of day two, very early morning. Yeah, that's how I'm going to paint there. There's a lot of spark over here. So I'm going to paint the chicken on there. We seem to be quite early because nobody's awake. I thought these homies get up early, bird. People sleep outside. Look, she's just laying there. With the kids on the mattress. I used to have chickens when I was 10 years old. For real? At our little shop nearby, they sold them for 10 cents each. And they used to lay with me in the bed, like here, on the pillow. The last was, that was like Brindley. And I remember my mother was like, fuck it, we had enough of these chickens. So I had to take the chicken over to the neighbor, Mrs. Gillian, and she, I had to hold the chicken and she slaughtered him. And then we ate him. I vow never to buy chickens for 10 cents again. The Bushmen are great people. They also welcome outsiders, mainly because they can see potential for help from everybody's interaction and everybody's willingness to tell us about who they are and their struggles.
Kom ek sê jou die eerlike waarheid. Ons as Boesmans, gebore Boesmans, is die oudste nasie. Hier's nie 'n lokasie, huise vir mense nie. Jy het nie meer hy vryheid wat jy altyd gehad nie. 'N Mens kan mos hierdie wiel 2000 jaar terugdry. So ons moet dit mos nou aanpas by die moderne. 'N Mens moet die lewe aanpas, maar jy moet nie jou kultuur en jou tradisie vernalatig nie, want dit is wat jou maak met jou is jou kultuur en jou traditie.
Daar is tekortkoming, mense wil graag dorpstichting, hy wil graag huise hê. Ons kan met mekaar hier verskil op die grond. Ons onder mekaar, maar nie een buitenstaander kan my kom rondstoot. Ek is 'n boesman. Ek weet wie ek is. Ek is op my grond, so ek is vry.
So my ambition was to find out a bit more about Bushman art. Kind of see like an original painter of the style and technique still exist. So luckily we met David, I'm Kreper. He did what I wanted to see. He did it from the ground up with the building of the tools and the mixing of the paints. We're going to try and do a little collaboration. He took a twig of the bush, he got a Gemsbok tail, and he's ready to go.
Rock art, it doesn't really exist anymore. They're only doing it for survival, for tourism, where they're painting the ostrich eggs and the little stones and they're burning the bones. The dude that painted with me today has never painted on a structure in his life. Crazy that to them it doesn't even make sense that you can paint an upright structure, where that is actually the original purpose of what they do. I think it's sad.
Okay, bye, thank you once again.
I'll say that.
It's my new friend. David, I'm Kreper.
I think it's such a big leap in my understanding of where we are as street artists, that they once had their streets and they were the ones putting out there what they thought was relevant. And I understand what outsiders are coming in and be like, yo, this shit's real. You know, we need to save it. They are the original people. Original ancestors. With Once Upon a Town, I would like to try and do a lot more towns in South Africa. I'd love to go to every little rural town in the Eastern Cape, every town in the Karoo, Valley of a Thousand Hills in Natal, and just paint 10 homes. I believe that South Africa, as a disjointed country, needs a lot more help. With Once Upon a Town, what it has taught me is that my belief in the beginning about what I'm doing is right. To see the people's joy, it's priceless. You can't put money to it. I don't want to do anything else. If this is all I can do until I'm 65. And by then have other artists incorporated into the project. I think I would have achieved something. It's what I'll do. It's all I'd ever want to do.